Hi guys, I'm Sonal and welcome to my channel. Today I'm making almond butter at home. The reason to make almond butter at home is, firstly, it's lovely, wonderful, creamy thing that I love to eat. Second, or the main reason is that it's expensive to buy it in India. It's extremely expensive, and if I start eating it, my children want to eat it too. They like to eat it with flat bread. They make a roll out of it and eat it for breakfast a lot of times. So, it doesn't last in my house at all. So that's the reason I decided to make it. And almonds are abundantly available in India, so why not make it on your own? It's a very simple and a 3-4 step recipe. It takes time, but it's not like you're standing there watching it happen. So let's go ahead and see how it's made. So you want to put these almonds in a big pot and have at least 2 inches of water above it, because they are going to soak up all the water and plump up. The reason to soak the almonds is that when you soak any nuts and seed, the nutrients in it become more bioavailable and it becomes easier to digest. You can easily skip this and go to the part where you toast the almonds in the oven. I like to do this because it just makes a healthier almond butter.
After soaking, they plump up. They are much bigger in size. So I want to show you the difference between a dry almond and a soaked almond. Lighter one is the soaked almond and this is the dried almond. It has plumped up after absorbing all the liquid. Now you're going to take the soaked almond, put it in the oven, and I let it dry out completely overnight on the lowest setting that you have. If there's water in the almonds, your almond butter will get spoiled. For that reason, you want to completely dry it. This is what I have done to these almonds. They are almost dry. I want it to have the toasted flavor. So I'm going to let it go on about a setting of 4 and let it cook for about like 2 hours or so. They are completely dry now. I want to warn you, I have burnt 2 kgs of almonds twice. You want to keep a close eye on it. It has a lot of oil. Once the almond heats up to a particular temperature, it's going to quickly burn. Now we are going to run it through the food processor on a slow speed for about 5 to 10 minutes and then go by what it looks like. 2 minutes later, this is what it looks like. We are going to keep it going for 3 more minutes.
3 more minutes. Scrape the sides.
And you could add salt at this point or even later. 1 tablespoon of ghee has already gone in. I'm adding another tablespoon or so. And hopefully it'll come together with that much. Or else I'm going to add some more later. It's almost come together. You want to add a little more fat. So whichever fat that you like, butter or ghee, you can add at this point. I'm going to add some more ghee and some salt. So I've added about 1/4 of a teaspoon of salt, 1.5 tablespoons of ghee. Salt will be completely as per your preference. You want to make sure that you add enough salt to flavor the things that you're going to eat with it. Look at the texture. I think it's perfect. I'm going to give it a taste now and put it in a jar. It's time to taste the almond butter. After all that laborious work, take a look. How beautifully runny it is, with loads of lovely healthy ghee. So the almond butter tasted great. I like the fact that I made it with ghee, because ghee solidifies at room temperature, so you can even store it outside and it won't separate. But if you make it with oil, the oil separates, it comes to the top, and you're left with the thick or hard almond butter at the bottom. So this was a great recipe. It's not even a recipe, it's just a bunch of steps put together and then you just keep tasting and make your own. I really like this one. First of all, it is a cheap alternative to the ready-made one that I can buy here in India. This can go really well with flatbreads, in salad dressings. It can go well on normal breads with some honey for the children. You can mix it up in some cocoa powder and make different flavors out of it. You can store it in the fridge. My children are going to eat it with flatbread. I just take a spoon and eat it just as it is. Give this recipe a try, especially if you live in India and it's difficult to find almond butter here. And let me know how it turned out. Also, if you make any variation, let me know in the comment section. And if you've enjoyed this video, please give me a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel. Thanks for watching. Bye.